chance.
Wait them out. Mind you,
he won't let us eat.
Won't let us hunt. He's got us. We're gonna die in here.
Season is nearly here, which means millions of people will be heading for national parks and national forests. As it turns out, a few of them won't be coming back.
Each year, hundreds of people are reported missing in our parks and forests. Most are eventually found, but there's a smaller category of cases that never get solved, including a few close to home. The iTeam's George Knapp is here with the story. George.
It's not a revelation to say that people get lost out in the wilderness or in forest areas. We're talking about a different kind of mystery, though. Disappearances that are not caused by predator attacks or criminals hiding out there in the woods or just bad luck. A former cop has put together hundreds of case files regarding clusters of missing persons.
Andrea.
Easy, boy. Easy.
I want you to turn the caravan.
Yeah, it does.
Shut, is it? Bridge?
Yes,
uh-huh.
Where are you heading for?
The Loch
Ness,
Sky Road.
Sky Road, okay. Where exactly are you heading for?
Well, I was going to go down just somewhere down the road and stop.
Ian.
But there's such a jam back there to go over onto the other road to come back.
The best option for you, are you heading for Sky?
Well, that road, yes.
So if I was you, I'd be going back to the A9 and then heading for Sky that way, because this is an absolute shambles tonight.
Is the bridge stuck, like?
Okay. So turn round. Okay. You guys should go down here, double backing yourself.
We'll do that.
Turn left and hit turn.
Okay, thanks.
How are you stuck?
The day we'd be fine. Any other day we'd be fine.
We're stuck here, thanks to you people. Sick of this, sick of waiting. Bob's out there, our friend. Every second we wait here is a second lost.
We're on a mystery tour.
I'm gonna be walking the park.
I hope they'd hatch before I had to go to the boat.
It's 22 years later, and it's been a lot of fun because Colin has a great deal of passion and investment in honoring the characters as Michael Crichton wrote them and has gone back to the book and I think done a pretty good job of.
You're lucky.
Charlie, you didn't let you start as well.
Load on the side.
Thank you. the same thing. Calm down, Bob. You're safe. But now... Well, that was the end of me.
Well, it nearly was. They are Velociraptors and they're very vicious. And very nasty. Not like the films, they're far worse. Calm down.
Come on, get your stuff. We'll be back. Big numbers. You'll see. Come on, I'll explain how I survive. Follow me.
And you.
Where does this fucking thing go?
Far too far.
Where's your house, child?
It's up there. That's where I hid. For 6 months I was alone. Up there was a foul thing.
And if it should be still there, don't wait for it.
That is alien.
Home. For 6 months I lived here. Something's not right. Something's not right at all. The dead have reawakened. Must investigate.
Is it a trap?
Undoubtedly.
A trap.
Gonna do what?
dragon.
To San Francisco.
I'm very sure that you don't have to draw on my past experiences to formulate your equivalent for the novel.
Peace that's only to be found on the other side of war. If that battle must come, I will fight it.
Get out of here, you Daigle bastard!
Big, very big. What species is this?
That one's a Carnotaurus. That's a Carnotaurus.
Heard,
my friend.
Heard it. Fully risen up like that. It picks the top of the branches, you see, where it gets most of its nutrition. Down here is just for the smaller animals, you know, your Triceratops, your stag.
That much here you've never seen before. It's amazing.
Look at that one, it's just like a big cairn, a Triceratops there. And Bob, I come away from there, that's a bull, you don't want to mess with that one. Come on, come to me,
What do I do with this one?
Run! Run to me! Run right now! Run!
Okay.